Hi, this is Queen Ifama. I am a truth terrorist. And today, I'm doing this video based on a conversation that was taking place on the radio. Because generally, you know, sometimes I call in. Let me put this gum out. I don't know why I don't remember to do this when I come to talk to y'all. But I just forget all about it because I'm so used to chewing it. But anyway, the conversation today was about, do we see the police in our community as occupiers? And I'm going to say the police have always been occupiers in the community, whether they were police of white folk or police and black people. And he was saying how white people have a different view of the police as opposed to black people. And I was like, you know, I called in and I said, well, that's due to the fact that before they even started hiring black policemen, white police brought to the job their own prejudices about black people. And they would treat them accordingly. They didn't have prejudices against white people. So, of course, they would treat them a little more cordially. But, you know, if you look historically, the police ain't never been liked by nobody, really, except for the one in trouble at that particular time. But overall, nobody really cared for them. And I think that it has a lot to do with their mentality. You know what I'm saying? Because I think that policemen overall are just bullies. They have a bully mentality. You know what I'm saying? And that's why they get on the force, is so that they can have power to their bullying. Because I see a lot of bullying, you know, with police officers and stuff like that. And so, you know, like I was saying on the radio, this is what I think. I think that had black communities been policed by black policemen, I don't think we'd probably have the same attitude for the police like white people do. Because, you know, he was saying that white people overall don't have a problem with the police. And that's because they don't experience the same things that we do in general. Now, this is generally speaking. I'm talking about driving while black and all the other kind of things that happen specifically to black people. White people don't have those kind of problems. Now, the ones who've been in trouble with the police probably don't like it. But overall, the white community generally doesn't have a real negative image or negative thoughts about the police department. But with black people, because it appears that they've come and occupied our community, and they're actually policing the community. They're not serving the people, but they're actually policing and containing the people. As a matter of fact, sometimes I think they're just there to make sure that that stuff is contained, that it doesn't go over certain borders and lines and stuff like that and spill over into other communities that have, you know, a lower percentage of black people. So I think overall, you know, black people have a whole different perspective in general about the police based on experiences that they've had personally, as well as experiences that they've had, you know, through relative, you know, not that they've had, but that they've heard through relatives and friends and, you know, different things like that. But I'm going to say that they are a necessary force today, because we have such a lack of respect in the culture that, you know, it was a time when a criminal at least had a little respect, you know what I'm saying, for children and women and people on their way to church and stuff like that. But today, they just don't have the same type of respect. Even the criminal element doesn't have the same respect even that they had when I was coming up. Because I was saying that I knew some criminals that I knew that had more integrity than some church-going folk that I knew. And that was back then, as the society continually deteriorated psychologically, because that's exactly what has happened, is that we got a psychological deterioration in the society. And I want to tell you is that I think one of the things that we gloss over a lot is the foundation of this society, and that's its culture and what its culture's roots are. And nobody wants to really address that, because when black people start talking about culture, we go all over to Africa. Well, we're not in Africa. We're here subject to the culture that we're in. And I think that culture needs an examination. And I remember us being tagged as having post-traumatic slave syndrome But I'm going to tell you that we're perfectly normal if we have that diagnosis by someone based on what has happened. So it ain't, we're not the problem. It's not us. We're just reacting to what's happening to us collectively, I would say. But I think that that boy, that European that comes out of that Greek society, all through the Roman society, and even prior to that, boy, I'm telling you, I've been doing some really research on those beginnings, okay? And I'm going to say to you, and this is because this is in their historical record. See, so that's why I can pinpoint them so much. Missy, I wish you would shut up. Every time I do a video, she starts to talk, and that irritates me. Or I get on the phone, she starts to talk. Just like a kid, you know, like when you have a child and you get on the phone, now all of a sudden they want everything. That's how she does. I just got through feeding her. So I don't know what's her problem, but she better, you know, get on. I'm going to have to give her a little surprise if I can find one, because she's just real. But anyway. So what I've been doing is, get out of here. There you go. See, now she's gone. See, what I've been doing is a little study. I went on my shelves and pulled out some books that I started reading but never really completed, because I kind of like drift from one subject to another. It depends on, you know, kind of like what mood I'm in. But that's why I know a little bit of some about everything, because every time I come up with an idea, I go get some information on it and I'll start reading a little bit about it. But I pulled out my book, The History of White Folk. And I suggest that, what's a history of white people? I suggest you read it. Pull it off the shelf. It's a really good book. I think you should read it. Because I think that we diagnose ourselves a lot. And even though I admit that, you know, we could do a whole lot better, but I think that the state that black people is in is a direct result of what has happened to them here in America. Now, I'm not excusing it, because we do have the power to change that. Psychologically, we can change that. You know, our actions and our behaviors, particularly with one another, you know, and creating solidarity with each other. I think we have the power to do that. However, I still think that there is a core of negativity. And, you know, when I look at back at Greek society and then the barbarians, the Romans, I mean, they were really barbarians, but the Greeks were barbarians as well. I mean, they come from a barbarous society. You know, they have very barbarous beginnings, okay? So when they went through their dark ages, their ages of enlightenment and stuff like that, they learned culture from other people like Moors and things like that, you know, from what I've heard, because I haven't really read that, but you know, I've heard plenty of discussion that said that, and I'll have to do my own research on it, so I'm not trying to regurgitate something that I don't know. But, you know, I think that seed, that acele is what Marimba Ani calls it. I think that acele is still in each and every one of them. You know, it's just this little seed that has this, you know, this negative way of looking at life, and wanted to conquer everything that comes in their path and control everything that comes in their path. Now, I'm not one who believes in the theory of the ice people and the sun people. I don't believe in that theory, okay? I just think there are certain species of human being. That's what I think. And I think that, you know, because we have so much documentation about them, where they've documented their own stuff, you know, because black people were mostly verbal people, you know, so we told stories. We didn't do too much writing shit down after, you know, the Egyptian era or whatever. You know, we didn't do too much writing. We did a whole lot of passing shit down verbally, you know. And of course, as we can tell, even passing shit around in a circle, shit does have a opportunity to change by the time it gets to the end, right? So that's why you got to take even that with a grain of salt. But what I want to say is, you know, when we're talking about people who have the power to govern, you have to look at their beginning, okay? Black or white. And like I told the guy on the radio, my dear brother, is that you know, he said, well, black people complain about black police too. And I say, yes. Once blacks were allowed on the force, it became this kind of club mentality. Like, you know, it became groupthink, you know? So now you got black folk who will subject other black people to basically the same thing that white folk do. Now, the only thing I have to hear yet is a black person say that they were driving while black and it was a black cop that pulled them over. I haven't heard that yet. Okay. I wonder, do black police pull over white folk? I've never seen it. I drive down this road every day. And every day I see people stopped on the road. I don't see none but black people being stopped. I mean, and if they're young black men, they're sitting on the curb with their hands behind their backs and their trunks and car doors is swung wide open and the police is searching. But I don't see black police pulling no white people over in the city of Milwaukee. I just haven't seen it. Now, that doesn't mean that it hasn't happened. But I happen to see all the time black folk being pulled over by white policemen. I just find that very interesting, particularly if they go through these little towns and, you know, like Milwaukee got a line, right? You cross this line, now you in West Dallas, or now you in South Milwaukee, but it ain't nothing but across the street, okay? So you cross that line and nine times out of 10, the police force is all white or it got one Hispanic on it, okay, who think he white, all right? So any black person that come through there is suspect. Period. Okay. So, you know, I'm just thinking that it's cultural. See, we talk a lot about the white supremacist system, which I don't believe in. I know it's a system of oppression, but there's a cultural basis to that system of oppression because these people have a history of oppressing people, even other white people, because they didn't have white classifications in the beginning. Okay, so they would oppress people, period. So we have to look at the culture, I think, and that's why I, let me tell y'all something. Culture is so important to me. It's because I know that is the root of our behavior. Because your culture dictates to you how you do it, when you do it, and who you do it with. That's what your culture dictates to you. You see what I'm saying? And so we're under the auspices of a European culture. You must remember that the people who came over here on the Nina, the Pinta, and the Santa Maria, and all those other ships that came over here from Europe, that they were Europeans. They brought their mindset and culture with them. The only thing for some of them, they wanted to separate their religions. But basically, their assemblies are intact, is what I'm saying. Okay? So, you know, my studies now is more focused on the culture because that is the same culture, just modernized, that we're in today. I mean, even from the arenas, you know, the gladiator effects, all that stuff is really being replayed in football, basketball, hockey, boxing, you know, all of those bloodthirsty ass games that was played back in Rome and back in Greece, they're manifesting today. So it's literally the same type of mentality in the culture, in the society that was spawned through the European. Because we're definitely not practicing what we have talked about as African culture here. We definitely, I mean, the one that they told me about where Africans were so good and kind and, you know, all this kind of stuff. I'm like, they done come a long way from where they used to be. Okay. And I mean, just studying the history of them, that has been manifested to me. You know what I'm saying? I ain't talking about just the 60s, the 50s, the 40s, the 30s, the 20s. I'm talking about going back in black history. Okay, so before all of this stuff based on race manifested, okay? So I think the culture is the key. Understanding this culture, dissecting this culture, and changing your way of looking at things so that this culture does not have a negative effect on you. You see what I'm saying? Because the morals and values of the everyday person are basically the same. So, you know, for me, I think it's pertinent for me to really look at the culture that I'm in and the values and morals of the acele of this culture, the seed of this culture. Okay. So anyway, I hope y'all, you know, think about that because, you know, we could skate around this all we want to, but until we get to the core of negativity, we're going to always have problems and it's going to always start with the individual. So once you start changing and controlling your mind, then you'll find that your life will be a little bit sweeter in spite of all the obstacles that anyone could put in front of you or anyone can tell you that you can't do this and you can't do that. We got plenty of history that tells us that people have been able to do what they want to do regardless of all the barriers that has been put up. There have been people with the determination and the tenacity to do what they want to do. So with that said, study the culture, not just African culture. I'm talking about the culture that you're in. Study that culture. And I guarantee you, you may come up with a whole different understanding of where you are and what you do and why you do it and who you do it with. So this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. Peace, everybody. Have a great day.